Hi, it's Stacey here from stacymyers.com, and today we're going to learn how to put a Feedburner RSS feed onto our WordPress site. So the first thing we're going to do is go to Feedburner. And Feedburner has integrated with Google, so you can use your Gmail account to sign into that. And it takes you straight to the page where you're going to add in your feed. So we put our website in here. I'm not using my website as I already have a feed for it. So we're using goyagirls.com. You can, if you're a podcaster, you can tick this. If you're not, you just leave it. And then if you'd like to go back later, you can tick that and then make any changes to your feed that are necessary. Just click next. Okay, and then you can choose whether you want it to be the feed, which is the blog feed, or whether you'd like it to be the feed from the comments. And I'm going to have the feed come from the blog post, not the comments. And so this just tells me my feed title is Goya Girls, and the feed address now is feeds.feedburner.com/Goya Girls. Just click next. Okay, and so basically the Feedburner feed is live, so you can just click next again, and this just tells you that the stats that it will talk about for you, how many people have subscribed, what feeds the readers are people are using, whether that's like Yahoo or Bloglines or Google Reader. You can also work out how many click-throughs you have back to your website. You can choose any of these yourself. And that's it. Your feed is all up and running. And then the next thing you're going to do is have a look where you want to place it. And for today, of course, we're doing the WordPress self-hosted website. And so it gives you a comprehensive breakdown of what it is that you can do to put that on your website, but I'm going to take you through that. So the first thing we need to do is get our feed. So it's this feedburner.com Goya Girls. So if we go back to a website, so here we are in Goya Girls, we're going to add the Feedburner plugin to our site. So we go plugins, and we're going to add a new plugin, and it's Feedburner that we're going to search for, and search plugins, and here it's the first one that comes up. So you want to install that now? Yes, we do want to install it. Activate your plugin. And then, if you come down into settings, you'll see down the bottom it says Feedburner. If you open that up, then you need to come back and get the Feedburner feed. So remember, it's goyagirls.com feed. Actually, we're going to use this one. And then at the end, you're just going to type the Goya Girls and then press save. And then, so now this Feedburner has been set up for your site. Now, as I'm still building this site, I don't have any blog posts on here, so I'm just going to take you back to my site. And then I have here the icon for my RSS feed. So if you click on the RSS feed, it takes you, will take people to this page. Now mine subscribe with Google comes up by itself because I have set that as my favorite reader, but people can subscribe to all of these other various RSS feed readers that are out there. So people would then say if they want Google, then you can just click Add to Google Reader. And so that the RSS feed for my blog has now been added to that reader for people. And so then they can just go in at their own leisure and read any of the blog posts that we have there. So that's how you set up an RSS feed for your website. Inside Feedburner, if you don't have the icon on your website, if you want to go to publicize, you can get a graphic from in here that says subscribe in a reader. And if you scroll down, it will give you the code down here to use, which you can copy and paste and put into your website. So if we were going to put that onto my website, we go into the dashboard of your WordPress site. Into the widgets area, and then we're going to just use a text widget. So you take the text widget over wherever it is that you want that to appear on your website and just paste the code in there. Make sure you save it. And then you'll see here that it links now, people can click on that and it takes them back to exactly the same place as it would have with the icon that I have on my page. If you have any questions how to do this, please just put them on my Facebook page or in the comments section of my website and I will answer any questions that you have.